Islam does not belong in our society at all. Not just here. Islam does not belong in any place where there is any reasonable existence of people. People with arms does not belong there. Let me give you one simple example. In a reasonable society, in a society where there is reason, you should have picked your religion through your choice. And you should have the liberty to leave your religion with your choice. You should be able to do both of those things. With Islam, you do not do both. How many Muslims here actually became Muslims out of your own volition? Out of your own volition, how many Muslims who are here became Muslims?
Me.
When did you become a Muslim, sir?
Last year.
When did you become a Muslim? Hello, how are you doing? How many Muslims became Muslims out of your own volition? Not because your parents said a few strange things in your ears, but you chose to become Muslims. How many? You, my dear football friend, are you a Muslim who became a Muslim out of your own volition? When did you become a Muslim, sir?
Last year.
When did you become? Why are you scared, sir? Did you become a Muslim out of your own volition? Did you become a Muslim out of your own volition? So clearly, Muslims have been too concerned about how to wipe their bummy, because they lift up their bummy in the act of saying praying. Because they are so focused on bum-related activities, they are focused on how to wipe, how to use water to clean, and so on. But we Christians are focused on more important things. So let me ask you a simple question. How many Muslims chose to become Muslims out of your own volition? How about you, sir? Did you become a Muslim when you were an adult?
No. I'm born Muslim, alhamdulillah.
How can anyone be born? So in other words, you didn't choose to be a Muslim?
I am proud to be a Muslim.
No, I'm not. Did you choose to be a Muslim?
Yes. If I would choose, I will be.
Excuse me, sir. How exactly did you choose when you were born?
I did not say that.
In other words, clueless. So, my dear friends, in a civil society, a person must be able to choose his religion out of his own volition, and should be able to leave his religion out of his own volition without people disturbing him. Neither of this is true with Islam. Islam does not belong in our nation. Islam does not belong in our nation. Did you choose to be a Muslim when you were... Are you a Muslim, sir? Did you choose to be a Muslim when you were grown up? So, when did you become a Muslim? So clearly you were a Muslim when you were born. So you didn't choose to be a Muslim then. Is there a Muslim here who chose?
You do not belong here. Takbir!
What's your problem?
Takbir!
Did you choose to be a Muslim when you were born? You see what is happening, my dear friends? My dear friends, do you see what is happening? This gentleman, don't touch me. This gentleman is a walking example, and most of you are walking examples of the fact that you do not follow a religion which belongs in our nation at all. Most of you did not choose your religion. Neither can you choose to leave your religion at peace. The demonstration was the gentleman who was shouting out. He wanted beer, clearly he was in the wrong place. Did you choose to be a Muslim when you were grown up, sir? No. Listen to the question again. Did you choose to be a Muslim when you were grown up, sir?
I was born a Muslim, why would I be?
So clearly, again, the same nonsense. People whose religions are determined by birth. Can you imagine the level of nonsense that's happening here?
I haven't finished.
This guy did not choose his religion. He was brainwashed into his religion. As a matter of fact, Islam abuses children on a daily basis. You should go to a place.
Have you guys been abused? Were you beaten at home?
abused? Abused anyone? Any Muslims
there? I say, when did you start reading the Quran, sir?
When I was small.
Wait, listen to this, please. When did you start reading the Quran, sir?
When I was born.
And when did you start memorizing the Quran, sir?
When I was born.
When you were born?
What? When I was born. When I was small.
When you were small. Did you choose to do it? How old were you?
3, 4, 5 years.
3, 4. Did you choose to memorize the Quran at that time, or were you just made to do it?
Did you choose to go to school, or did you choose to do that?
When you were 3 years old. What else did you choose when you were 3 years old?
Did you choose to go to school?
Yeah.
When you were 3 years old, what else did you choose? Don't come near me. Look, if you, excuse me, if you want to keep, bring your hand near me, stay away. Thank you. Thank you. So let me ask you, what other things did you choose when you were 3 years old, sir?
When I was 3 years old, I choose to play with my toys. What's exactly your point?
With your toys, yeah. Did you choose?
I choose to play with your toys. Did you choose?
Yeah, I choose.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I know choosing.
Move your hands away from him, bro.
I know choosing.
Move your hands away from him.
He is the one coming close to me.
I didn't come close.
Excuse me. I have been standing here for a while. You have been desperately coming close. If you think the space isn't enough, stay away. Stay away. If you think the space isn't enough, stay away. Stay away. Stay away. So, I've been staying here. You can stay away. No problem. Now, with Muslims, with Islam, what happens? Most of you guys, you have been made Muslims as a way of indoctrination before even you grew up, without having the option to leave Islam when you grow up. When you leave Islam, what is the penalty for apostasy in Islam, sir? Any bold Muslim, if you were to apostatize, what would your penalty be? Keep your tongue inside. You don't belong here. That's in a prostitution place. Try that elsewhere. Clearly, you're so used to sexual immorality, which goes with your religion, so no wonder. So let me ask, how many of you know the penalty of apostasy in Islam? Anyone?
Penalty
for apostasy in Islam.
Death penalty.
Penalty for, wait a second. So we have a problem. You did not choose your religion. Neither could you leave your religion at peace. Now he is running away. What is the penalty for apostasy in Islam? What is the penalty for apostasy in Islam? Anyone, brave Muslim? Are you Muslim, sir? Yourself?
Yes, I'm Muslim.
Okay. What is the penalty for apostasy in Islam?
Many people left Islam.
So that's not what I asked you. What is the... Many Muslims are drunkards. Does that matter? Question is, what is the penalty for apostasy in Islam?
Depends on the country.
Depends on the country. According to the Quran, today, if this were to be an Islamic caliphate, what is the penalty for leaving Islam?
I'm not here to debate you.
In other words, you won't answer. You're too ashamed. Maybe you're too ashamed or you're too afraid. Maybe stay at home. If you want to leave Islam, don't ever think about this, because Islam doesn't even give you the permission to do this. Any brave Muslim who is willing to engage in a conversation where you can give meaningful information about apostasy in Islam. If you were to leave Islam in an Islamic caliphate, what would the penalty be? Any brave Muslim? Any brave Muslim? We have chickens everywhere. Any brave Muslim?
Just say, bro. You know
chickens, yeah. What are you doing here, my dear friends? Do you not? Absolutely not. Do you think Christianity is even comparable with Islam? You must be a joker. Wake up, read the Bible, my dear friend. You need to read the Bible. Islam, just because Islam is horrible, you think Christianity is like it?
Which Bible?
Now stop your ranting. Ranting nonsense, stop. Question, in an Islamic caliphate, can you choose to leave Islam, my dear friends? What is the penalty for apostasy?
Because I believe
there is no reason. Okay, so there is a reason to become a Muslim then. When did you choose to become a Muslim?
When I am born.
So in other words, clearly clueless. When you were born, okay, tell me. When you were born, what were the criteria that you looked for before you became a Muslim, sir?
Rather than looking at Islam.
Listen to me again. Please listen.
You listen to me.
When you were born, what were the criteria you were looking to become a Muslim, sir?
After that, I speak.
What were the criteria to become a Muslim when you were born?
Okay, you're looking at Islam. Why don't you look at Christianity?
In other words, you haven't got a clue.
No,
you're the same chicken. Same chicken. Same clueless chicken. Same clueless chicken. Clueless, indoctrinated. Apostasy. What is the penalty for apostasy? This gentleman with his beard, maybe he can answer. What is the penalty for apostasy in Islam? In an Islamic caliphate, sir, what is the penalty for apostasy? You, sir, you said you wanted beer earlier. What is the penalty for apostasy? Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Stay away. Don't touch. Don't touch. Stay away. Stay away. Don't touch. Don't touch. Stay away. What is the penalty? Sir, you tug beer. You shouted out tug beer earlier. So I'm assuming you know what you're talking about. What is the penalty for apostasy in Islam? Clueless. So, my dear friends, Islam does not belong in our nation. Islam does not belong in our nation. And one of the important ways we understand that Islam doesn't belong in our nation is by the fact that you neither have the liberty to choose Islam after you are grown up, nor have the liberty to leave Islam. Most of you were indoctrinated into Islam. It does not matter how much money you have. Does not matter how much money you have. It does not matter what other education you go through. The fact of the matter is, you are blind, clueless chickens who can't stand up to the truth and have a sincere and bold conversation. Islam does not belong in our nation. The problem, that we have with Islam is not just that apostasy is punishable by death. What is that? Are you a Muslim? You are. So please, when did you choose to become a Muslim?
Like 3 years ago.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Sorry. Don't touch
me. He's allergic. Don't touch me.
3 years ago, bro.
3 years ago. What were the criteria you were looking for to become a Muslim? Don't come near me.
Don't touch
please,
me.
Please. Give my personal space. I have my personal space.
Don't touch me. He's allergic, yeah?
I didn't understand. Sorry, bro. Can you repeat?
On what basis did you choose Islam?
I'm Christian, bro.
You are Christian. Right? That's right. So, we're talking about how Islam doesn't belong in our nation. That's what we're talking about. Cool. Thank you. So that's why. I need to move on. Thank you. If you give me space, thank you.
Don't touch.
Give me my space. You are assaulting me. Give me my space. Thank you. If you stay away. All right, my dear friends, clearly all of you Muslims have agreed that you are clueless, typically indoctrinated. Don't come into my personal space. Give my personal space. Stay away. All of you Muslims have clearly agreed that Islam doesn't belong in our nation because you are shameless, clueless. Excuse me. Don't get into. So clueless Muslims can stay at home, enjoy your Arab holiday somewhere else. But if you don't want to follow the rules here, excuse me. Don't touch me. Stay away. Don't touch me. Stay away.
Racist. Speak to someone, you're not going nowhere.
All right. It's an assault. Stay away. You are a youngster, clueless as usual. Get home. Sleep on your bed. Stay at home. Don't ever touch me again. Stay at home. Stay at home. Thank you. Now, clearly, all of you Muslims cannot think for yourselves. Clearly, you have demonstrated this. Grown up, physically growing up, mentally, I don't know what's happening with you guys. I am trying to wake you guys up. Because the more you physically grow, I like this gentleman, your mind seems to be going downhill. I am trying to wake you guys up. Clearly, look at this cartoon character. He is fit to work in McDonald's. You know, as a comic, I can see this clearly. Physical growth, mental growth, not much. And so, my dear friends, leave Islam while you still have the liberty to leave Islam. I won't care what happens to your phone. Don't encroach into my personal space. You are clearly retarded. Listen to what I'm saying. Don't come into my personal space again. I am not happy. Don't even come into my personal space. Stay away. Leave Islam as early as you can. The more time that you take, your own family might end up killing you. Leave Islam while you still have time. Are you a Muslim, sir? You are. So in Islam, for apostasy, what is the penalty, sir? In an Islamic caliphate, what is the penalty for leaving Islam? What is the penalty for leaving Islam in an Islamic caliphate? What is the penalty for leaving Islam in an Islamic caliphate? Clueless. Clueless like usual. Not a great idea. Don't come here. My dear friends, my dear Muslim friends, look at all the Muslims here. Either you are showing. Either you show. Look at, please. Look at all the grown up children. Look at him. Maybe about. Don't touch. Stay away. Look at the child. Spot the difference, my dear friends. Spot the difference between the 10-year-old and the 30-year-old. Islam has frozen your brains. Islam has frozen your brains. Even though, spot the difference between these two guys. Spot the difference. 10-year-old, 30-year-old, same quality of thinking. Same 10-year-old, 30-year-old, same quality of thinking. Can you see what Islam does to a person? Can you see what Islam does to a person? They either come here.
I'm telling you multiple times, get away.
So you need to cover it. You need to cover it. This guy is shouting me.
You have assaulted me. Stay away. Stay away. Stay away. Clearly, clearly, stay away.
They need to cover it.
So.
Ray, if you cover free, me free, here, free, I'll cover them.
Free, free, Palestine!
Free, free,
Palestine!
Free, free,
Palestine!
Free, free,
Palestine!
Free, free,
Palestine!
All right.
So, we are in the show.
I am more
I was assaulted.
I gave my hand. Oh, look at
you. Touching me by
the step to one side. Let's just step to one side.
I don't want to move. I don't want to move. I want to stay here. And I want you to try and help me. Because there was a guy assaulting me, screaming at me.
Yes.
And I want to make sure you help me. You speakers corner in a proper manner. And that is whereas I understand things could be a little bit heated. I want my space and I don't want people screaming into my ears and so on.
Yeah,
thank you much.
So
you clearly see.
The point is, you can't do what you want to do in the circumstances.
Excuse me, sir. So what's your problem? So please, sir, what's your problem?
Out!
Guys!
You do not have to be here, right? Step back! Hyde Park's a big park, you do not have to be so close. Do what you need to do.
So, my dear friends,
can you stop and start again? Right?
All right. All right, dear friends.
Whenever someone has an answer, run away. That's
so the point that I was making very clearly earlier was very simply, Islam is not fit for purpose, at least on two counts. Islam is not fit for purpose, at least on two counts here. Number one, most of you did not choose your religion, number one, which is so unlike a good society. In a good society, you should be able to choose your religion, number one. And number two, the more serious problem is that you can never leave your religion where Sharia is in operation. You cannot live. Doesn't matter. But the facility to leave your religion should be there for it to be a proper choice, not that of indoctrination. And that is my point. Islam.
None of us chose our religion.
You assaulted multiple people. Please stay away. Thank you.
None of us chose our religion.
Please stay away. Apostasy is punishable by death. Jesus, on the other hand, is marvelous.
He didn't want a visa.
Christianity, on the other hand, is marvelous. You chose to become a Christian at the time of your choosing. And at the time of your choosing, you can leave the religion if you wanted to. That is what liberty is. That is what freedom is. And that is when we know, when someone becomes a Christian, we know you have become a Christian for proper reasons. Islam does not give you this opportunity. Islam does not therefore belong in our nation. Neither does Islam belong anywhere where people want to make sense. So my dear Muslim friends, leave Islam while you are still in the UK. Leave Islam while you still have the liberty to leave Islam and be protected at least by the rest of the nation, even if not by your own community. Leave. Flee. What is that, sir? So you ask a question and move away. Intelligent Muslim there again.